Lecture soon, so please turn on your camera. Okay, so thank you. As you may aware, this is our last lecture for this class. We will not have a final exam. I mean, conventional final exam. So in replacement of that, you need to submit a complete set of report. The report should contain all the reports that you have submitted throughout the semester. You need to compile them and then present it as a single integrated report. Okay, you need to add some section to make one section can be related to the other section. Okay. I'll upload the minimum requirement for the report. So what kind of content of the report you need to submit later before the final exam. So then you need to submit your group report on the date and time of before the date and time of your final exam ended. Okay. So that's for the final exam. Okay. Any question about the final exam before I continue with our last topic today? Oh, okay, but okay, as always, if you have any question, you can ask me using email or Microsoft Teams chat later on. Fine, let's continue with our last topic, which is system maintenance. Okay. Okay, can you see the slide?
Yes, sir.
Yes,
okay.
Sir. Yes, sir.
Thank you. Thank you. So, system maintenance. This is the last stage on system development lifecycle, as you may see here, from planning, analysis, design, implementation. This is maintenance. So, when the system that you have developed fails and delivered to the customer or the client or the whoever else. For the new system, then it should be handed over to people who manage and maintain the system. Remember, in accounting information system, the segregation of duties in the computerized information system environment is consists of people who develop the system should be separated from people who maintain the system or manage the system, and also separated from people who use the system. So user, administrator, and developer should be separated. And that's what's being practiced in industry, in a lot of companies, not small companies perhaps, but in the big companies that have dedicated IT department, they will have separate IT operation and also IT development. The problem with those separation is how to make sure that system being developed by IT development department can be transformed and transferred smoothly into IT operation. And that's become a discipline now, maybe not a separate discipline, but become a trend that's called the DevOps, development and operation. Okay. So once the development finishes here in the design, it will be implemented, and then it will implementation involves the operation and development, or developer and also the administrator. And then after it's finished, then it will be taken over by the administration or IT operation. Okay. So maintenance is the longest phase in system development life cycle. Yeah. This is where the finished system being used for daily operation, being used for it the intended function, and so on and so forth. Some system could be in maintenance for short period of time, maybe a year or two, three max. Some other system have been in operation for longer than that, more than 30, 40 years. I've seen some story in the some news outlet, for example, the system that been installed in some old airplane like Boeing 747, they still use floppy disk, and floppy disk has been used since the 1990s. The first time I learned on how to use computer was using that floppy disk, the big 5 inches floppy disk. Apparently, that's still being used by some airline company to update the system in some airplane. The US government, especially Department of Defense of the US government, they still use 8 inches diskette floppy disk. 8 inches floppy disk is even older than 5 inches. Remember, in regard to computing physical size, the newer the computer, the size will always, the physical size will always be smaller. So 8 inches diskette was one of the oldest storage media. However, the computer system used for controlling nuclear weapons of the US government was still using those 8 inches diskette. They still using a system developed in the 70s or even 60s. The core banking system, the system that some of the bank, especially the older bank, like perhaps Citibank, they still use the system that being developed in the 60s or 70s. Why? Because it's work. Okay. And it's still working perfectly, capable of fulfilling the need of the organization. So that's the mantra for any information system. as long as the system is still able to fulfill the need or requirements of the organization, don't touch it, never replace it. Replacing new system, replacing old system with new system is always problematic. You introduce something new to organization, it will always have a problem with it. Some problems are small, others are big and could have significant impact. So if it's everything goes smooth, never touch it. Okay, so if it ain't broken, don't fix it. Anyway, so there are four major activities in system maintenance. First, obtaining maintenance requests. Second, transforming requests into changes. Third, designing changes. And fourth, implementing changes. So maintenance, in essence, is a smaller version of system development lifecycle with smaller scope. So instead of a complete new system, maintenance probably will cover only smaller subset of a system. Perhaps somebody said that they could not print the document as intended. So you fix that printing capability. Somebody said they could not send email. You fix that. Somebody said they could not produce invoice. You fix that instead of the whole system, changing the whole system. Okay, so this is a sample of service requests. Some said it will, in a modern organization, it will be replaced by ticketing system. You probably have been using that. Let me. So, so this is the sample of service requests in our organization. So you need to fill out this information, and then you can select what kind of problem or service request you want. Like, is there any problem? Is there any request? Is there any suggestion, perhaps? Okay. With the problem, because system consists of hardware, software, and network, you need to be specified, specific about what's the problem. Is there related to the internet connection? Is that related to data mistake, error? Is there any application error or what? Okay. It could be that the error related to hardware. Okay, perhaps your computer could not run the system properly because it's under perform, or your tablet is not good enough to run the system. That doesn't mean that the system or the information system or the application having problem. That's the hardware problem. So that's the become the problem for a maintenance department to understand which problem needs to be addressed and what should be done. If the hardware is the problem, we need to fix the hardware rather than the application or system. Okay, let's return to this. So the deliverables and outcome, if basic, so like I said, is basically a subset of the whole development process with smaller scope. So the deliverable and outcome is the new version of the or improved version of the software or system. But instead of a big version number from version 1 to version 2, for example, this will produce smaller version number, like perhaps version 1 to version 1.001. Okay, so what the maintenance type? First is corrective maintenance. This is to repair or fix the flaw in the design, coding, or implementation. Sometimes, even with extensive testing, we could not foresee any future problem because we don't cover that in testing. Take a look at Microsoft, for example, with Windows. Every time Microsoft releases Windows, there is a lot of problem. Why? Because Microsoft Windows are used with so many versions of computers. Okay, some are old, some are new, some have a very quirky hardware, some have a very different software, things like that. So it's impossible for Microsoft to test the new version of Windows with all of those versions, with all of those circumstances, with all of those user setup, because there are billion of them, billion variation. You know, in some scenario or situation, even different brand of mouse could create a problem. For example, a few months ago, Microsoft released a new update for their Windows 10, and apparently it makes some Epson printer stop functioning. So if you have a Epson printer with specific type and version, that wouldn't be able. So the latest Windows version could not print using that Epson printer, and that's become a problem. Okay, so corrective you to change that. And then adaptive maintenance, changes made to a system to evolve its functionality to changing business needs or technologies. For example, many years ago, our academic system was designed to handle student ID with 4 digits. But then our faculty admitted it's 10,000 students. So we need to change the student ID from 4 digit to 5 digit to accommodate the student number 10,000. Okay, we need. Perhaps there is a change in regulation. For example, a few years ago, Bank Indonesia required all ATM system in Indonesia to change the PIN code from 4 digit to 6 digit. And recently, there is another regulation that required all ATM card stop using magnetic stripe and start using chip for the processing. So the bank have to make some adaptation, some changes to their system to accommodate this new regulation. A few years ago, the European Union starting to implement the General Data Protection Regulation, GDPR. So now, when you visit a website, those websites will inform you about cookies, and they told you what kind of cookies they will send to your computer and asking for your permission. Okay. That's because of the GDPR implementation from the European Union. Perfective maintenance, this is a change made to system to add new feature or improve performance to speed up things. Okay. For example, in the old system, in the existing system, to do a transaction, you will need like 4 or 5 seconds. But then, after they make some optimization, it will cut the time from 4 or 5 seconds to 2 or 3 seconds. Okay. Maintenance, changes made to system to avoid possible future problem. This is usually for security reasons. So software from third parties like Windows, Office, yeah, sometimes they have a flaw or security problem inside. So, and then immediately the vendor of that software will release an update. And if our system having the software, we need to update the system immediately to prevent problem, especially security. It has been found that many times security breach in high profile companies happen because of the flaw in their software, third party softwares. And apparently the third party already released an update to address that flaw in their security, but the company failed to update. So this include update in antivirus, for example, Windows, or even hardware, changing the hardware to address the weaknesses. Okay. So throughout the lifetime of a system, the budget for maintenance could be as big as 80 and as small as 60% of total information system budget. Okay. So when we design the system, we need to take into account the maintainability. Okay. How easy to maintain the system. Okay. Let me give you an example. There is a website called iFixit. Okay. These guys here, whenever there are new gadgets released, they will buy this gadget and then tear it down. Why? To see how easy to fix that. For example, they try to see M1 iMac here. They dismantle this M1 iMac and to see how much effort need to fix this. Okay. The higher the score, I don't know how much, how many scores they got here. Okay. Anyway, so they will give score. They haven't got any scores. They give scores for easy to fix. The bigger the score, easier to fix. So what's this have to do with maintenance? Okay. So if a device hard to fix, and this is the fault with many Apple products, they are very hard to replace, then it will be costly for them to fix in the future. Okay. I had an iPad Air 2 that has expired. I bought that in 2014, and also I bought Apple iCare for that. But it expired in 2016. In 2017, when I tried to fix it, the authorized Apple service center refused to fix it because they could not, they didn't have the spare part. So I have to find another way to fix it. Okay. And that's very costly for company. Okay. So this is the cost of maintenance. So what the factors that influence system maintenance? First, the latent defect. This is the defect that not yet being found. Okay. Number of customer for given system, quality of system documentation, maintenance personnel, tools and well-structured program. So this is the quality of document. The better the document, the lower the cost of maintenance. Because if you have complete documentation of your system, for example, there are error in printing, then you can go directly to printing module and fix the problem there. Okay, instead of going through all the software one line by line. Okay, managing maintenance personnel. Again, a lot of people looking at information system work, mostly looking at development work rather than maintenance. But maintenance is also an important work. Okay. In fact, I think, and it's been supported by this slide, the number of people working in maintenance has surpassed the number of working in development. Because nowadays, in a lot of companies, they tend to outsource their development, but they still have people for maintaining the system, for desktop support, for user support. Okay. However, it's not a glamorous work. If you work for support, user will dump all their problem to you. Okay. And the fact that sometimes the support personnel is less than capable or incompetent only exacerbate the problem. Okay. But all organizations need to have this maintenance personnel. Okay. So, okay, this is just the organizational. So, how to measure the maintenance effectiveness? First, we need to look at the number of failures, time between each failure, and type of failures. There's a measurement called mean time between failures. This is a measurement of error occurrence that can be tracked over time to indicate the quality of the system. The bigger the mean time between failures, the better the quality of the system. It means that the system could go on and on and on and on for very long period of time. For example, a TV, any LCD or LED panel TV, could go for 100,000 hours mean time between failure. So between two failures, they can operate smoothly for 100,000 hours. If you watch TV, say 10 hours a day, it translates into 10,000 days. So if it's 1,000 equals, so it could last about 30 years, a TV. And a lot of TV last less than that. I mean, usually people will sell their TV nowadays in 3 or 5 years. Okay. So controlling maintenance requests. This is very important to manage the workload of the maintenance personnel. So let me get back to the help desk example here. So for example, if the request is just categorized as suggestion, we could ignore that. I mean, not ignore it, but we could handle that later. But for example, there is an error in class registration application during the registration period here, then we need to address that as soon as possible. Username. You forgot your username, you forgot the password. It could be fixed immediately. Okay. But if there is a problem with internet connection, for example, the internet provider having difficulties, then it could take days to fix that. Okay. So that's how we should manage the request. We need to priority based on type and urgency. Obviously, the most urgent will be fixed first, and the less urgent will be dealt last. So, like I said, suggestion usually will be categorized as low priority. Okay. So this is change request. What type? Is it corrective? If it's corrective, then it will be priority and will be done correct immediately. If it's other, if it enhancement suggestion, it will be dealt later. But if it's adaptive or perfection, it should be done immediately. Now, system that being used for daily operation should not be touched every so often. Only authorized changes are made to the system. Okay, and if you learn about audit in information system, one of the things that the auditor will look into is the authorized change. If the auditor found that there is a change in the system, the auditor will try to find any evidence who proposed the changes, how the changes being analyzed, and who authorized the changes. Okay. If those documents could not be found, then the changes are illegal. Okay. So we have baseline modules. This is the version 1.0 of the software, and then the next changes will change it into 1.0.1. Okay. Okay. I'll skip this.
Sometimes,
when and this is happen quite often nowadays, people who originally developed the system has already left the companies long time ago. And then there's a problem. The current people who handle the system didn't know, and the documentation is not really helpful. So we need to reverse engineer. Reverse engineers means from the existing system, we will dismantle the system and see the logic behind the system. So it could read source code and then create a diagram based on that source code. Okay. So some of the, but I need to be honest, a lot of these reverse engineering tools is not really helpful. Why? Because usually reverse engineering tools are created for a single language, computer language, programming language. But nowadays, many applications consist of many programming languages. So it's not possible to reverse engineer with just software. Now, the other consideration is for website maintenance. If your system is web-based system, then you need to consider the availability of your website. Naturally, all web applications should be available 24/7, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year, or 366 if it's leap year. Yeah. And this especially true for a critical system like banking system, airline system, ticketing system for airline, air traffic controller, you know, all the system that handle critical function. Okay. So with website, for example, we need to check for broken links. Validate the HTML. Validate the HTML means that we need to make sure that our website with HTML language comply to the standard. Register the domain. Although this is a simple and very short process and cheap, if you forget to register the domain, then user could not browse to your domain. Okay. It was actually happened with PT Telkom 20 years ago. So PT Telkom has this domain called telkom.net at that time. It was international domain, not Indonesian domain. So what happened was somebody forget to renew that domain. To renew that domain, it was simple. Just go to the domain provider and then renew by using credit card for payment. Unfortunately, at that time, circa 2000s, Indonesian credit card or any transaction with credit card from Indonesia at that time was deemed as fraudulent. So a lot of payment with credit card from Indonesia was rejected by the provider. And that happened with PT Telkom. The request to pay the domain renewal with credit card was rejected. due to many fraud in credit card transaction from Indonesia at that time. So they need to find somebody that actually have overseas credit card and pay for that. So that's simple, but still need to be done. If you have a very valuable domain, a lot of other people want to buy your domain. If you forget to renew your domain, other people could then buy that domain. Okay, and that happens. Okay, so this is. Okay, that's for maintenance. Any question? Okay, now for closing, my closing remark for this course. Obviously, we never expect you to be the expert in system development after finishing this course. It's far from it. Okay. System analysis and design not only required theoretical knowledge, okay, which what you had here is only introduction. This course were in informatics program, it will be labeled as introduction. Okay, you need other courses like programming, data structure, requirement engineering, things like that, to be able to develop a full functional system. Okay, that's not the intention of this course. You will not be able to be system analyst. You need further training. That's what I was saying. However, later on, after you finish your study and you work either as owner of a company or an employee, especially in managerial position, you know what are your options. You know what you need to do. If you need an information system, you know what to do. You know how to analyze roughly. You know what your option. Most of the times now, instead of developing your own system, you can just buy something in the market. It's available. You can also outsource your development. However, you need to be very careful with buying and outsourcing. You need to think of the long term rather than short term. For example, if you buy a software, you need to look at how dependable your company to that software. If it's very vital to your organization, you might need to think of to develop that software rather than buying. Because in modern business, especially in IT industry, companies come and go. Okay. What it used to be as like 10 years ago, Google is nothing. Facebook is nothing. Okay, they're starting to grow big, but that it used to be nothing. 20 years ago, the biggest computer makers was Compaq. Have you ever seen any Compaq computer nowadays? No. Because in 2005, Compaq computer was acquired by Hewlett Packard and now become part of Hewlett Packard. 30 years ago, IBM probably the best or the biggest in IT. Nowadays, it's nothing. Now we know Microsoft is one of the giant. Okay. 20 years ago, Amazon was bookseller, online bookseller. But nowadays, Amazon is cloud provider, also multimedia company, with streaming video and still have the retailer part. Who knows what else? Okay. So you need to think about it. Okay. If the software or the system is so critical to your company, you need to think about developing that software on your own. Because if you depend on a vendor or an IT company, it could be went bankrupt, it could be acquired by somebody else, or it could be merged with other companies, regardless of their current position. Okay. So that's the intention of this course. Okay, that's it for this semester. Like I said, I will let you know in the coming days the requirement for your final report. And any question before I close this session? No? Okay. That's it. Good luck with your studies and see you in other event or in other bottom line is I don't want to see you again in this class. Okay, so see you in the future.
Thank you.